Well, the Rhinos seeking a third win of the year against a side that so often has tormented them in the past. They beat St Helens in extra time in that Cup semi-final, of course. 7 days earlier, they beat them 24-16 at Knowsley Road in the Super League. But the Saints, coming into this match on the back of their 34-38 defeat by Wigan last Friday, and they maybe will take a little bit of comfort from the fact that that was the most points they ever scored in a losing match. But they failed to win any of their last three, and they've won just three of their last 10 in the Super League. It's a worrying time for the reigning champions. Let's take a quick check on the way these two fine sides will line up. Leeds have Connolly at fullback. It's Calderwood, Walker, Senior and Cummins in the three quarters. Duneman and Maguire will share the work at halfback. Up front, it's McDonald, Diskin and McDermott. Ferner, Adamson is back and Sinfield. And the substitutes, Burrow, Feather, Poaching and Bailey. And the coach is Daryl Powell. Now the Saints, not many changes despite that defeat by Wigan. Wellens at fullback. Stuart Gleeson, Albert's in for the injured new love, and Gardner, it's Sculthorpe and Long. And the forwards, Britt, Cunningham and Mason, joint Bennett and Darren Smith is the loose forward. And on the interchange bench for them, Hooper, Ward, Higham and Tim Yonkers back in the fold for coach Ian Millwood. Well, the Saints are outside the top six as we reach the halfway stage. And we cannot remember another time when Saints dropped out of the qualifying places for the grand final. Last October's second grand final win in 3 years is just a distant memory for these players now. They've played 13, they've won six, they've lost six. Who would have predicted that at the start of the year? Seventh in the table as the race for the top six finish really begins to gather momentum from here on in. The Leeds Rhinos, though, 10-0 down against Castleford last Saturday. Daryl Powell's men claimed his 100th victory as a coach. That's including his spell at Keighley Cougars. And it followed their fight-back win at Wigan the week before. They never know they are beaten this year. It's a quality that all in the Super League will envy. Their mix of youth and experienced players is currently the talk of the game. Out comes Chris Joynt. Saints in their traditional white and red with the red V. And they will soon be followed by the Leeds Rhinos. But never before have they been under the spotlight like this, the Saints. But out come the league leaders. And we will be watching tonight two of the free-scoring sides in Super League. More than 130 tries between them. Both have solid defences as well. It, Steve-O, on a night like this, shirt sleeve order. It has all the makings of yet another Friday night classic.
Absolutely, and look at the crowd here packed into the Headingley ground. Some are confident that this will continue on, others are a little bit sceptical. St Helens, of course, it's down to pride. I'm sure that Ian Millwood would have said to all his players as they walked out from the dressing room, just take a quick glance into the mirror, and there's a man that I suspect will be put under a lot of pressure in the opening quarter. Gary Connolly's had an absolutely superb season, but he was completely out of form against Castleford last week. Very rare you get two bad run games by the fullback Gary Connolly, and a big night for this fella, Carl Kirkpatrick.
Yes, he's had charge of some big games this year. Wigan Saints, Leeds Bradford. Now Leeds Saints, we're underway. Sculthorpe's kickoff. Underneath it, Sculthorpe. There's the first run by Barry McDermott. And there's the first tackle by Martin Gleeson. I have a feeling we are in for a very, very special Super League night. It could be a classic. McDonald, great tackle by Britt, helped out by Joynt. Good start defensively by the Saints.
I'm sure
that push and a shove as well. Duneman with a kick downfield. Bounces kindly for Anthony Stewart. Has he dropped back to fullback, Stewart? Good chase. Good chase led by Diskin. Great tackle.
Good work from Leeds there. Great tactics. You can see that the lengthening shadows there means that Saints have got the sun right into their eyes.
And Stewart has dropped back to fullback. Wellens is standing on the wing. This is Keith Mason now, and there's the sun that will be troublesome for the Saints in this first half. Britt will drive it forward. Great tackling by Ferner and McDonald, who gets the pat on the back. Cunningham, the dummy half. Sculthorpe taking them on.
Biggest problem for Leeds, though, is the fact that at times they've been very slow to start. Can't afford it against the Saints, but I think they'll go for the full 80 tonight.
The kick from long, fielded by Calderwood. Wellens gets to him with a little bit of help from Ady Gardner. Plays the ball, does Calderwood, to Chev Walker. Bounces off two. Mason and Cunningham combine to bring him down. Sinfield, here's David Ferner. Such an influence at Headingley this year. Good drive forward, midway inside his own half of the field. Plays it to Diskin. Now McDonald. McDonald thought briefly about the offload. Diskin again. McDermott drives it forward into the chest of Darren Smith. Pretty and with solid. The help of Bennett, the tackle is effective.
Pretty solid defence as well. Interesting that Wellens has now drifted into the centre position.
Kick over the top to Ady Gardner's wing. It's a horrible bounce, and Calderwood has swooped. He's giving it to Chev Walker, and Chev Walker plunks it down. What a mistake by Ady Gardner. What a try from Chev Walker. What a start from Leeds Rhinos. Well, the bounce was deceptive. Gardner allowed it to hit the deck twice and paid the penalty.
Once again, utilising the sun, kept it low, did Sinfield, and rightly so. It wasn't the best bounce, but we remember, you just saw the shot of what he would have been looking at the sun. Great finish, but excellent work from Calderwood. It was a good kick. You can see that the ball was back spinning. And it's obviously the sun that has played a big part in this, but none more so than the strength of this big fella, Chev Walker. Sixes and sevens. He would have been half-blinded there, Gardner. But good support play. What a try and what a start. Looking for that second effort, and that's what Calderwood did. And he had the support.
Terrific drive from Chev Walker. He missed the league win at St Helens in April. He played second row for much of the time, and indeed in the Cup semi-final against St Helens, and he has looked awesome in the pack this year, but filling in today for the injured Chris McKenna. Kevin Sinfield then, not a bad success rate this year with the boot. Lengthening shadows, the inquest behind the post at St Helens, that will dent their confidence. Sinfield with the conversion attempt, it's a belter, and Leeds have a 6-point lead early, something they haven't had recently. They came from behind last week, now they lead.
And they've done it so often this year. It is a luxury, courtesy of this fella, Chev Walker. Played a lot of the time in the second row, but now drifted out back to his favourite spot in the centre. And maybe, who knows, Ian Millward may have to change yet again and may bring Ady Gardner back from the wing and swap him with Wellens, who's in that centre position still.
And Stewart still operating at full-back. Well, he has a fluid style, doesn't he, Ian Millward? And that's not the start that he would have planned for. But here now is McDonald. That's a good tackle by Wellens. And Joint was on him quickly too, and Britt drives him back a couple of yards also.
You've got to take advantage of all the positive that's going for you, and Leeds have done that. That's the second occasion they've cut right into the corner. They know they're going to be... It's a big problem this sun. And they'll get about 20 minutes of it, Eddie, I feel.
Or maybe a bit more than that. It's early summer, and here's another kick from Dooneman, right down the middle of the pitch this year, in between the two, Albert and Stewart. Albert is the man who picks it up. Restored to the side tonight, Darren Albert. He missed last week. He hasn't scored in the last three, though. It's the worst run of his career. This now is Anthony Stewart. Or rather, it's the worst run of his year, not his career. Darren Albert.
I'll say... Running caution by Cal Kirkpatrick there to the lead skipper, Kevin Sinfield. Went pretty high on Stewart.
Darren Britt will drive it in again. That's great defence from Leeds. Diskin and McDonald with a big hit.
That's been the difficulty of the Saints. They haven't been able to get the roll on with the forwards, and they certainly need it.
Oh, the pass from Long is misdirected. And Gleeson got to it. And they've lost a little bit of ground there, Saints. Scunthorpe with the kick in between Connolly and Calderwood. Calderwood chases this enthusiastically, and from his own line he will run it back. Wellens is after him. Good tackle by Paul Wellens.
Good chase, six players flat. They know the capabilities of this winger, Mark Calderwood, deep from within his own half. He's created some wonderful tries already this season.
Last visit to Headingley for Saints last year, they won 41-14. Higham and Stewart got a couple of tries apiece. Scunthorpe a try and six goals. And head-to-head, take a look at this. They have had the better of things, the Saints, over the years, particularly in the summer era. Sinfield with the kick again, a wicked one into the sunshine, and Gardner again, and it's another wicked bounce. This time he pouches it safely, but Chev Walker following up hungrily.
Both sides equal to the task. Good kick and chase game so far. You expect that the early parts of the match, but St Helens really would be better served just getting back into the swing of things, utilising the forwards. They've got to have big games from Darren Brent and Keith Mason.
Here is Mason. That's a big hit by McDonald again.
Oh, the two Max are really in for this one.
Here's Darren Britt. Good ball to Darren Smith. Good tackle by Danny Burrow. Danny Maguire. Kieran Cunningham. Paul Scunthorpe. Angled kick. Long is after this. But it's claimed by Connolly.
That'll do his confidence the world of good. Made it quite clear, he didn't have his best game against Castleford last week.
Good tackle by Wellens on Walker. Quick play, the ball to Calderwood. He's so electric from dummy half. Sinfield. Now it's McDonald again.
A lot more zip in this Leeds opening.
Diskin. McDermott. Looking to offload McDermott. That's the fifth and last for Leeds this set of six. Just over halfway, and McDermott's injured. He got a strained knee in the back then. Grimaces as he gets to his feet, plays it to Diskin. Left-footed kick from Sinfield.
Oh, he's in a bit of trouble, is Barry McDermott. Oh.
Anthony Stewart, he says it came off his toe. The referee was about 30 metres behind the play, and he said it came off his hands. Yeah, he's absolutely right.
No doubt about it. Unless he's got his toe around his waist. Well, both feet are...
Let's get filmed.
Once he gets the hands to that...
Well, he didn't say his toe, maybe he said his knee. But he played at the ball. And benefit of the doubt in a situation like that has to go to the opposition. Barry McDermott's just trotting back into the scrum. Here's Connolly. Connolly!
Good defence by Gleeson there. It had to be as well, sweeping up.
Maguire. Sinfield. McDonald. They know what he can do. Remember that wonderful try scored at Knowsley Road in April.
Keep your eye out for Ferner.
Diskin. McDermott.
Ferner standing very deep. Black on the inside from Dooneman, perhaps.
Sinfield misses out Ferner. Finds Dooneman. Gets it to Adamson. And Adamson... Harris to the ground by three. Four tackles gone. Can Saints hang on? Dooneman, here's Ferner now. There's the last tackle. Saints will get a bit of confidence from this if they can survive. It's with Sinfield, who'll dab the kick through. Another wicked bounce. And this time, they were alert to it in defence. Stewart did well.
Certainly did. Got a bad ricochet there. Just came off Darren Smith's back. Well did Stewart.
This is great defence from Leeds, though. 2-0 Hull lead against Wigan after 10 minutes at the JJB Stadium. Cunningham wrestled to the ground by McDonald. This is Darren Britt. Darren Britt loses it forward.
Play on.
Picked up by Senior.
Good refereeing there by Mr. Kirkpatrick. It was one-on-one with Britt.
Well, the pressure is enormous on St Helens. McDermott with the drive.
And it is one-on-one. Probably would have been deemed a forward pass anyway.
Diskin, good run from dummy half, finds Dooneman.
Ready well did Wellens.
Uncompromisingly put to ground by Long. Leeds secure with ball in hand so far. Maguire. Make the turn. It's been all Leeds for the opening 10 minutes. They lead 6-0. Connolly. Connolly. Still Connolly trying to make amends for the two little errors he made here last week against Castleford. Diskin waits at dummy half, 5 metres away from the line. Sweeps it to the left and finds Sinfield. He gives it to Ferner. Wonderful tackle from Bennett.
Wonderful, and there's nobody there. They've just got there in time.
They keep the ball alive, though. Kick cross field, and there's two against one here. Gardner with it all to do.
Knock on.
Who's knock on, though? On the last, it's the turnover, says the touch judge.
Well, it's certainly either Walker or the winger, Mark Calderwood. Well, they've had seven sets of six of Leeds on the trot, not failed to complete them. And that will be a stat that will be pleasing their coach, Daryl Powell. St Helens, they've only completed two out of the four. Mistakes are plenty from them.
What a wonderful start for Leeds, Phil.
Yes, it is, really. When you think about it, there's times in a game when you're in control and dominating your opponents, and times when they're doing it to you, and the best teams can handle ball at the moment, Saints certainly under the cosh, but here we'll see what they're made of. I thought that you saw early doors, the great marker defence from the Leeds Rhinos kept Saints deep inside their own half. Well, on this occasion now, they've got up over the halfway line. This will be some pleasure in attack for them.
And they have a little bit more pleasure now because Leeds are caught offside at the play of the ball.
They'll probably punch this straight into the corner there on the right, and that's what Long is doing. Not the best kick, though at least he's made sure that they get possession.
And here now is Bennett again for St Helens. First time, really, St Helens have pressurised this Leeds line with Darren Britt now. They're within 3 metres of the line, and there's only two tackles gone this set of six. Cunningham pops it back. Chance here for Bennett.
Strangler defence is absolutely superb from both sides, I must say.
And a chance here from dummy half.
He's got it down,
I think, Cunningham.
Oh, could be close.
Held up.
No, he's celebrating. They don't know that the official... Oh, now he wants to have a look.
I'm pretty certain he got it.
Well, he said he gave the impression that he was held up. He was ready to give the... He gave the sign. And maybe he's got it right. I think he doesn't get it down. Oh, well, I think it's down. This will be given.
But it was down and then pushed back.
Yeah,
but it's on the deck.
Yeah, it's there. It's a try. They've hit back in no uncertain terms there from the hooker, Kieran Cunningham. Sheer strength. That's try time.
Well, Cunningham was very quick to celebrate, but it's all in the hands and the eyes now of Steve Cross, tonight's video referee.
Well, it's combined with the ball, and that's a try. No doubt about that. That's TRY on the screen. And well, great relief for St Helens.
Let's see what Steve Cross says. He agrees. First time they've threatened the Leeds line, and Ian Millwood's men have scored the try. Kieran Cunningham, the Welsh international, fifth start in a row at hooker. And that was a trademark try from him.
Confident build-up as well. And they're utilising the big forwards. Just a little bit lazy here. He got low. They try to lift him up. That is just sheer strength. Second effort. Just a little bit slack here in and around the first and second marker. Just having a little bit of a lazy luck there. He did well. He went for one of the smallest players in Danny Maguire, did the hooker, Kieran Cunningham. Well deserved.
Yes, a great try from Cunningham, just what they needed. And Sean Long is the goal kicker tonight. And Long has dragged it the wrong side of the posts. But he's a little bit out of sorts just lately, is Sean Long. His pass earlier on was behind the running player, and he's just missed with that kick.
There you see, he went for the small man, went for Maguire, tucked underneath him, bang. Tried his best at the standoff, but to no avail. Three on one, out of three, I'll make it four.
It's a try, says Ian Millwood. He didn't have to look at the screen, he was convinced. He saw his hooker celebrate. High kick in this sunshine. Difficult. Very difficult. And they're all leaving it to each other.
Just say the body language there that we saw of Ian Millwood. Not Ian Millwood of the past, is it? He would have been celebrating, arms up in the air, but he's playing it very, very cool these days. And rightly so. I think he wants to make sure that his players get all the headlines.
And also, Steve-O, he's not sitting pretty at the top of the table just at the moment. He's in seventh coming into this match. Whoa, now then.
Yep.
Lost it. Darren Albert lost it.
Well, it's mistakes like that that does not help. They've just seen themselves get back into this game, and then they come up with a simple error very early in the tackle count. That's been their problem so far.
Let's go, Leeds. Come on.
Leeds are getting through their sets of six.
And they're in possession here with Duneman. Connolly's on his inside. Good tackle by Wellens. Connolly now in at dummy half. The call was from Adamson. Here is Chev Walker taking on Long. Bounces off him. And also joint missed him. Oh, he's a real roughhouse this year, is Chev Walker. He's only 20 years of age. Terrific prospect there. Here is Duneman. Here's another great prospect, Bailey. He's only 19. We talk much about the Wigan youngsters. Take a look at some of these here at Leeds. Feather on the inside of Sinfield's pass.
Release!
St Helens with it all to do in defence here. Dart from dummy half by Diskin. And Diskin hauled back.
Desperation there. Joint clung to him like a landmine.
It's with Sinfield trying to go around. Gets the ball away though. Good offload from Bailey to Duneman. Duneman with a dink over the top. Cleaned up by Darren Smith. Trapped behind his own line. Goal line dropout coming up here for St Helens. Good work from Duneman. He's having a heck of a season.
Is he ever? Twist the tourniquet. And it stops the blood, and the lifeblood of St Helens is possession, and they can't get it at the moment. Good job that he got back to defuse the situation.
Let's go. Well, Sean, hold the line.
So a drop goal here, a drop out underneath the post here from Sean Long to Sinfield, and here comes Ferner. Oh, he's gone away from two. St Helens are hanging back in defence, and that could prove very costly. Here is Maguire, goes wide to Senior, flicked on the outside to Cummins, and Cummins trying to weave his way to the line. Diskin again. Here is Sinfield. Now it's with Duneman. There's a St Helens player flat out in back players. Connolly makes it to the corner. Connolly with a second Leeds try. Saints caught short in defence. A player was out on the far side receiving treatment, and Gary Connolly took full advantage of that. Well, he was a bit below par by his own high standards, but this week Connolly has started well.
Darren Albert was down in the back play. Beautiful linking between the loose forward and the way that Adamson came in on the angle. It's so effective, you know, the dummy runner. A lot of people claim that it is obstruction, blatant, but watch the man coming through, and it was significant that it allowed the space for the fullback. Wanted to try to get it, and well played, and yes indeed, because it was something that they've obviously been working hard at, but good play. Great to see players who are not going to get the possession of the football, they help and come into it. The teamwork this year from Leeds is outstanding.
A try for Gary Connolly the other week against Wigan, and a try here tonight against another of his former clubs, the Saints. It's 10-4 with the kick to come from Kevin Sinfield. He's been ever present this year as the Leeds captain. 5 goals from 8 shots against Castleford last week. And that's the angle he has here. Kevin Sinfield then for the Leeds Rhinos. And he's missed. 10-4 it is. Just a converted try between the two sides.
But you can see him just running through. Knows he's not going to get it. Didn't interfere, but it just put Sean Long off balance and in the wrong spot. No chance to stop this fella.
Keep it tidy down there.
Exciting times. I spoke to him last week after the game. He said he was disappointed with his performance. And it takes a true champion that can hold his hand up like that. But he is back to his best again at the right moment too.
Score from the JJB Stadium. Wigan are ahead at 10 points to 2 after 20 minutes. Good crowd inside there as well, I'm told, tonight. Big crowd here at Headingley. Bouncing times for the Super League as we reach high summer. Some great games all the way through the calendar. And Sinfield with the high kick, trying to keep the most of this sunlight. Here's Anthony Stewart. And we're featuring matches at top and bottom of the table this week. Saturday at 5, notice an hour earlier than usual. 5 o'clock, Sky Sports 1, Halifax, bottom of the table. Widnes, they have got ideas of a top 6 finish themselves. It's a vital game for both those clubs. Cunningham on halfway. Darren Britt driving it into the chest of Ryan Bailey.
Significant the way the fact that St Helens, they've had very little chance to attack in the opposition's quarter, and that's another mistake. Phil, this is going to be a big problem for Saints. They're not going to get out of the hole like this if they keep coming up with errors, simple errors too.
No, but I suppose all conversely, they can't retreat within the shell and just play one-out football. It wouldn't suit their style. As the referee just stops Gary Cunley from taking a quick tap penalty, players inside the 10. Going to try and carry on play the things the way that they've done in the past. It's provided them points in the earlier part of the season, and they'll look to do that again. I just want to go back to that try that Gary Connolly scored. It was amazing footwork the way he got round a player with the speed of Sean Long, but I think we should give some credit to Andrew Duneman. We've said he's been a very consistent performer. You see the stats on the screen, the fantastic completion, really. That just goes to show in any ball sport, if you hold on to possession when you have it and use it well, you'll tie your opponents and score some points, and that's exactly what Leeds are beginning to do. But I just wanted to go back to Andrew Duneman. His clever little chip into the in-goal area was what created the goal line dropout, and from that we then saw the Leeds try. I don't think we can overestimate just how important it is to win a goal line dropout from your opponents. The extra time you spend attacking their try line drains their energy and very often allows you to come away with a try.
Clarkey, that may be so, but I just get the impression that this St Helens side, OK, we know in the past that they've been very fancy football, keeping it alive, but there are times, I feel, when you've just got to roll your sleeves up and just start getting back into the game with the forwards. Nothing with finesse. Basic football.
Yeah, I'd agree with you there, Steve. I think last week at times against Wigan, they were just over-arrogant in possession. They had a chance, even in the second half, to come back and win it. They threw the ball around, really, when at times they needed to hold on and just play the percentage stuff. We'll see here tonight whether they've changed that approach, although if you were a St Helens follower for the last 25 years, you'd probably say they've had that approach. Sometimes it comes off of them, and other times not.
Kevin Sinfield missed with the penalty. 10-4 it stays. Sinfield to run this ball back at the Saints. Steve, if you ask for my opinion, which counts for absolutely nothing.
It does as far as I'm concerned, Eddie.
The Saints are playing like a classic car that's firing on about two of their four cylinders. Something radically wrong somewhere. Adamson. The passes that go astray, they force the pass. I don't know. Look at this, the way Diskin can make the cheap yards.
Well, it can be easy to come down from six cylinder to four, and even less, even to two.
Oh, look at that ball from Duneman to Adamson. It's the last tackle here, and it's with Walker, who finds Diskin, who gives it to Sinfield, and there's the kick, and this is dangerous. It's been knocked forward. It's hacked away. It was knocked forward by the Leeds man.
But even on the handover there, they know Leeds that they are in total control of this game. Senior just got the fingertips to it.
On the cross! Clearing! On the cross!
Been a bit quiet of late, Keith Senior. Start of this season, he was running very hot indeed.
He got a try last week against Castleford, but that was his first in eight games.
Stay in the line!
Just to emphasise the point you make. Britt now.
Two relays! Stay in the line!
Daryl Powell has to be extremely pleased with the opening performance.
Look at this!
Well, that's the price you pay when you play that very, very shallow and tight attacking game.
They don't seem at the races for some reason.
Well, they're taking their eyes off the football.
But
lack of confidence.
And they're gifting possession to the opposition deep inside their own territory, and all this defence will take its toll late on.
Without a doubt. And Daryl Powell,
on a night like this.
Daryl Powell knows that more than anybody.
Duneman then from the scrum. Gets away from Wellens, he can't get away from Long. It looked a little high from Long, but across the chest. And at Leeds, well, first half possession, it's all them, and here's Duneman.
Having to get through a lot of work is poor Wellens out there in the centres.
Saints trying to slow them down now at the play of the ball. Maguire, Bailey.
Look how they're getting over the advantage line so easily.
Diskin, Sinfield, looks left and right and they're flooding forward. Ferner, flick pass to Cummins. Great try. It's his 299th starting appearance and Francis Cummins comes up with try number 8 of 2003.
They're taking them apart. They were always going to be in trouble. Quick play the balls, making the yards, getting over that advantage line, as I say. You get, they call it putting the roll on, putting the heavy roller to them, and that's what Leeds have done. And when you've got finesse out wide, this is the mistake. Smith comes up with it, and then they just take it from there. Disappointed look on the face, but a lot dejected there. You can see that Sculthorpe was pulled out beautifully there by Connolly. He thought that he was coming into the line. What for the fullback? They think he's going to get it, but he doesn't. It looked a little bit forward, didn't it, on that side angle. Good work by Ferner. But again, we see the advantage of utilising the man that's not going to get the football. Didn't have to make contact, but it was enough to put off Sculthorpe having any chance to get to this man. Oh, that's a mile forward, isn't it? Yeah, that's a bad one. Well, Lady Luck has certainly popped up on that occasion. Not that it will help the St. Helens side and Ian Millward. But having seen that replay, it looked woefully forward, didn't it?
It did on that angle. And I must say, the touch judges these days are not giving the referees too much help. That's a much better kick from Sinfield. That adds a little more confidence to the Leeds side, 16-4 up, and will just knock the Saints back a little further. You feel they need divine intervention here.
Well, I've made it how it should be, but as we've seen on the replay, it didn't go back. There you go. He was just in front. No chance of the momentum coming into that ruling because of the fact that the loose forward, Kevin Sinfield, was actually stopped in his tracks. Doesn't come into play when that's the case.
Chris Feather played the ball. Quick play the ball is a feature of Leeds this evening. This is Matt Adamson. Diskin and Bailey taking on Joint and Darren Smith. Diskin again making good yards and St Helens' missed tackle count is rising again. This is Diskin again, and here now is Ferner. That's a good ball.
Well, it takes you back to that game at Hull, Eddie, when I think St. Helens came up with some sort of record. I think it was 25 missed tackles in the first half, which is just unbelievable, especially when you're talking about the champion side.
Mistimed and misdirected kick from Sinfield. Saints to restart 20 metres away from their own line, and this is Gardner. Cunningham, and here comes Keith Mason again.
Well, that's much better. At least they're just trying to work. Oh, that's an awful pass. Nobody knows who won.
I reckon that's about three or four that have gone behind the man already tonight.
You know how that's brought about? I'll tell you a simple rule. It's that those players are not talking to each other. They are certainly not passing on the messages.
Here's Long. Barry Ward must have said thanks very much for that. That's the last one. And there is Long's kick. That's a better kick. That's into the in-goal area. Long's after it as well. He'll try and pen Connolly down. And he does. Important and a great run from Long. Enthusiastic chase on his own kick.
Much better. More zip. And boy, it was needed. They need a big game from this fella, Sean Long. And it looks as though he's... well, maybe has he picked up an injury? Did well to keep him in. He goes all the way there. I think he's just out of breath. Just the sheer effort of it all. Gotta be honest, he only had one man with him as well.
He just looked at the bench, Sean Long, I can tell you, and he gave a little wobble of his hand, and he's just had a word on the run with the trainer. I don't think he's 100% fit. He's out of this attack, and this is Yonkers.
Well, he's joined himself into the link now.
And he's just put a signal up. Here's Barry Ward.
That was a mile forward as well.
Well, that's one each then.
Yep.
Cunningham. Long call for it. And here is Sculthorpe. And over the top to Jason Hooper.
Well, they don't know what they're doing.
Scunthorpe.
They look totally lost. There's no second phase.
Stewart finds Long. There's the kick to the in-goal area. Oh, it's bounced horribly. Could be a try here for Cunningham. What an awful bounce again. And has Connolly paid another price? Second try for Cunningham. He's claimed it. And the referee hands it on to Steve Cross again to check onside, offside and the grounding.
Beautiful kick by Sean Long. Right across the face of the goal mouth. They're all onside as far as that camera angle is concerned. So we'll go to see whether he actually got finger to the ball. Yep, that's okay. He comes from way out right. Oh yeah, he's well onside. Big mistake. We'll have to wait and see whether he got it down to Teta Firma.
It wasn't Connolly, it was Maguire. My apologies to Gary Connolly. Yes.
Ooh, yep. It bobbled slightly, but this will be a good one.
Well, it wasn't Connolly's error, it was Maguire who missed it. And the try is given to Kieran Cunningham. So, Cunningham with his second try. It's 16-8, kick to come from Long in front. Cunningham. Fifth start in a row, a dislocated elbow against New Zealand. He's back.
Well, they certainly needed this. And it was not the best effort, was it, from the standoff Danny Maguire. But full credit to this fella. He took a real one right in the chops as well whilst he was executing the kick. Cunningham, he's alive. So important through the years, Cunningham. And as this fella has been also. We got a game on our hands now.
Long adds the extras, 16 points to 10 at Headingley. The champions back to within a converted try of Leeds Rhinos, the league leaders, courtesy of two from Kieran Cunningham.
Amazing, amazing thing.
I don't think
thing.
He's breathing any easier, Ian Millwood, but that's a bit more encouraging.
Certainly there's a build-up just towards the half-time, and the man has pulled him out of so many scrapes over the years as this fellow, the hooker, Kieran Cunningham. Great to see him back into good form, two tries already. But it's an amazing thing, five tries we've seen put on the board. And three of those have come from drastic errors.
Well, can St Helens build some confidence from that? Barry Ward, straight at Sinfield. It took a flying tackle from Adamson to bring him down. There's Cunningham on a hat-trick now. Here is Chris Joint, great tackle from Dunham. Not the biggest, but he just stands his ground and puts the big men on the deck. Cunningham, Wellens! And Wellens is away from Sinfield. He can't get away from Calderwood, though.
Chris Joint caught one there.
Penalty against Calderwood.
On the deck, you let go of him.
Chris Joint is injured way downfield, and the trainer is really concerned.
I think he's got a bang in the nose, I think. Or is it his arm?
I think it's the arm.
There's blood everywhere, that's for sure.
Well, it could be the nose. It was pretty high from the pass.
Here is Jonkers, tackled by Adamson. This is Cunningham at dummy half. Here is Barry Ward, back to Kieran Cunningham. Cunningham attacking the line again. And Joint has got a real broken nose there. Ward!
They're getting back to basics now, Saints. Good, hard, solid rugby league.
Cunningham again. Thought about the pass. Sinfield did really well. This is Jonkers. Here is Scunthorpe. The pass was just a fraction behind him. Cunningham. Wide it goes. Held on by Gleeson into the crowd.
That would have been an absolute perler of a try. He often does this. There's Gleeson. Knew that someone was coming too. Cummings was certainly coming off the line and it just didn't go his way.
So near, so far. Chris Joint off the field. By the looks of things with a badly broken nose. Wonder if he'll return. No doubt Bill Arthur will be chasing the news.
Some big hits coming from Barry Ward out there on the Saints side. The South Stand claiming. This is Joint coming to it. Straight into head of Dunaman.
Yes, it was a clash of heads. Totally accidental. And Bailey is dumped to the ground by Darren Smith. There's Dooneman. Here's McDermott. McDermott spinning as he takes the tackle from Bennett. That's the last one on halfway. Sinfield dabs the ball through the middle.
Sensible kick as well.
Oh, Elvis! Oh. Well, they're going through the horrors.
Yep. Not much you can say about this. No pressure. And you really should use the feet when it's dipping towards you. If it's under pressure, you've got to be committed and go with the fingers. But not on that occasion, and he knows it. Well, this will be a nightmare for Saints.
It will be if Leeds score, and it's with senior to Cummins. And Cummins just juggled with it briefly. Tackled by Bennett, there's another penalty. Quickly taken, McDermott. Leeds laying siege to the St Helens line with Sinfield. McDonald!
So realise!
Saw the sets completed. Must be some sort of record that. 14 times in possession, 14 they've completed the sets of six. It's got to be a knock on, surely. That looked like a knock on from poaching.
It was, and there's the first set of six not completed.
I put the marker on them.
You did?
But 14 straight.
I think it's Jeff Walker, I'm not sure.
That is good work.
To me.
No doubt about it, Willie Poaching got a fingertip to that. And it is 15-14, as Eddie was right there.
But 14-6 for Saints. Clarkey leads near perfection.
Yeah, when you consider that statistic, it's absolutely amazing that St Helens are only 6 points behind. And the thing about confidence is nobody knows where it goes to. Nobody knows where it's come from. It's left the Saints camp for a while. But every so often, there's just a couple of signs in this first half that indicate to me it might be coming back slowly. I know they've made mistakes. Darren Albert being one of them, but one or two of the players now starting to lead the way, and they've hung on there, defended the line, look as though they might get to half-time. They'd be delighted if they could with just 6 points behind.
But Phil, it looks as though they're going to have to do it for the rest of the evening without their captain Chris Joint. It is a broken nose from what I'm told, and he's not going to be reappearing, and that is a real tragedy for Chris Joint in his testimonial season.
And Haim is on for Kieran Cunningham, the two-try man. This, meanwhile, is Barry McDermott for Leeds Rhinos.
Good choice as well from Millwood. Put someone there with a bit of zip. Maybe they can just sneak a try before half-time. Now it's Leeds' turn to show a lot more composure.
It's with Dooneman. And Dooneman comes wide to Poaching, who in turn finds Walker, a real handful. They just can't put this fella down. Three of them eventually do. It's the last tackle here. Walker to his feet, finds Poaching. Dooneman to sit in field, and here's the kick, a high one. Another tester for Darren Albert, this. Cummings got a hand to it. Just couldn't flick it back for Keith Senior, who was waiting.
No doubt about it, came off the Leeds man, that fellow Stuart Cummins, Francis Cummins, should I say.
Yes.
Stuart Cummins.
Stuart Cummins has just made a comeback, but not to the refereeing. Actually, I think in July, the week after the Origin match, if memory serves, the 9th, we will have Stuart Cummins as our guest on Boots and All. It's 12-8 to Wigan, by the way, at half-time over Hull. And there will be one or two interesting questions, no doubt, you will have for Mr. Cummins.
Well, let's say that I haven't buried any hatchets of late.
We will not be putting him to the sword, but we will be asking, I think, some interesting questions and asking him how his rule changes this year have gone.
All the questions I'll be asking, Eddie, is what the fans have been confused about this year. It's not me that's going to be asking the question. It's the fact that it's what the fans have wanted. They just want to find out where they're going. Are they getting better?
We'll see. They're approaching half-time at Headingley. Boots and All on Wednesday returns after a break for the Origin match from Australia last week. It's Wednesday at 8, Sky Sports 3, and Wigan's injured fullback Chris Radlinski will be our guest in the studio in London. And he'll be joined by Mr. Clark and I. And his club, Wigan, are winning at half-time against Hull in a real battle royal and amongst the top six. And this is a pretty big match as well, as we've said all night. And Barry McDermott looking for the penalty. It didn't come.
Well, it should have. about it. Jason Hooper, second goal on that one.
Dunham and all. It went back off the chest of Chef Walker and was picked up by Calderwood. And here he goes again. Here goes Calderwood again. Last tackle. Diskin, Sinfield. Sinfield delayed the pass, hit the deck. And it's still play on. It's still play on. It's McDermott. It's McDermott. Nearly a barnstorming try.
Listen to the crowd there. It's such a favourite here at Headingley.
I think St Helens believed that there was a knock-on there, but the referee said play on.
Well, they hesitated. And they nearly paid the full price there. They got back to him in the end.
Yonkers, St Helens will be glad for the half-time siren. Daryl Powell will be well pleased with this first half. They've been slow out of the blocks just lately, but not so tonight. 15 seconds to the break. St Helens in possession with Keith Mason, taking on David Ferner. Just back on. It's the fifth and last tackle this set of six. Here's the kick from Sean Long. But straight down the throat of Francis Cummings. Kick and chase maybe for Leeds, it's in the last minute. There's the siren. St Helens believe, I think, they have escaped a bit here. They've got to half-time trailing 16-10. Walker's try started it off for Leeds after only 2 minutes. A wicked bounce that deceived the St Helens defender. Cunningham hit them for two tries, but in between times, Connolly and Cummins scored tries for Leeds. Choynt's gone off with a broken nose. Probably won't see him again tonight. Leeds are ahead at the break by 16 points to 10.
Tomorrow, Sky Sports 1, England, Wales, Scotland continue their tour of the Southern Hemisphere. 7:30, Grand Slam winners England take on the mighty All Blacks. 10 o'clock, Wales face world champions Australia. And at 2, it's the second test between Scotland and the Springboks. The countdown to the World Cup has begun. Zurich Rugby Union tomorrow, only on Sky Sports 1. It's live. Live it.
Hello.
Come on.
Charles. Where's Joe?
Joe?
No, don't know where he is.
With its intelligent protection system, the Ford Mondeo is one of the safest places to be.
Mwah.
Are you paying too much for your car insurance? Just ask. Call 0800 444 777 for a great deal from the AA, Britain's biggest car insurance broker.
To grip at each corner, at each moment. That's our commitment at Michelin. Michelin, high performance time and again. And for exceptional driving performance, the new Michelin Pilot Sport.
New Clinamin Advanced gives stains the brush off.
It's their most incredible free flights offer ever. The Mail is giving every reader a free scheduled return flight to any one of 10 fabulous holiday destinations. You choose where you want to go. Yes, your chosen destination guaranteed. There's a free return flight for everyone to the destination of your choice, starting in tomorrow's Daily Mail.
When it comes over me, and I totally lose control, I like it.
All the rage. All the power. Unleash the fury. Hulk the game.
Excuse me, signore. We've lost our wallet.
Lost credit or debit cards on holiday can lead to all kinds of unpleasant excursions. But now, if you take American Express traveler's checks, with just one free call, your lost or stolen cards will be cancelled and replacements ordered, helping you spend your holiday on holiday. New credit card cancellation service from American Express Traveler's Checks.
Minnie Minoso, the Cuban Comet. 1957, he won baseball's first Golden Glove. He wasn't the fastest outfielder, didn't have the strongest or straightest arm, and as many could jump a hell of a lot higher. But out there, he'd get an inkling. When that ball flew, he'd be waiting for it. Put out 340 batters in just one season. But that's not luck. That's being in the right place at the right time. And that's what brings home the bacon.
Another Super League weekend. The Saturday match takes us to Halifax, a vital game against the Widnes Vikings. Widnes after a top six spot. Halifax, they are more interested in avoiding the big drop. It's a 5 o'clock start on Sky Sports 1. And after the State of Origin on Wednesday, which was live on Sky Sports, we go back to the NRL. And we have two more games this weekend as usual. Penrith Melbourne is the live Saturday morning game at 10:30, Sky Sports 2. It's Canberra Brisbane on Sky Sports 3 Sunday. Plus all the tries scored this weekend, that is a 10:30 start as well. Right now it's half-time at Headingley. Leeds Rhinos 16, St Helens 10, but a fantastic first half if you're a Leeds fan. Almost a perfect 40 minutes of rugby league from Daryl Powell's men. So safe with the ball in hand, so big in defence. They've been breached two times, of course, by Kieran Cunningham. But it has been a very impressive opening 40 minutes from the league leaders. What about the champions? What can we say about them? It's been a stuttering 40 minutes from them, to be fair. And they look as though they are blowing away without an exhaust at the moment. A classic car that has come upon some mechanical problems. But the Saints are not champions for nothing. And if anyone can bounce back, they can. We use the word in the build-up to this match, confidence. We wondered how the St Helens confidence would be coming into this match. It was a key word you used, and the confidence looks low.
I think the execution looks low, Eddie. I think their confidence is fine. They're trying to play some football. I think Leeds have set their stall out to play at the other end of the field where they're dangerous. They've decided with no frills, no fusses, find the floor, kick the ball. We saw from the first try, the bounce of the ball went Leeds' way. They were jabbing away at each other, and then all of a sudden Leeds have a 6-point lead. Saints have tried to play their way out of trouble and come up with some errors. Now, everything that Saints are doing is fixable. If they can get down to the other end of the field, what we've seen is, I think they've been there twice and we've got 10 points on the scoreboard. So that's what Ian Millward will be focusing on. He'll be saying, hang on a minute, guys, get to the other end of the field and look what we can do. Now, Leeds will be saying, let's continue with what we've been doing. Let's not make the errors and let's play the footy at that end of the field. And that's one of the keys to beating such a good footballing team like St Helens. You've got to play them at their end of the park where they're less dangerous.
There were a lot of times, though, in that first half, I lost count, maybe four, five, six, maybe, where the ball went behind the man that was being passed to.
And that's that element of anxiety, Eddie. That's that element of execution when your confidence is down a little bit. We did use the confidence word, but they're standing up there. They're not hiding, are they? They're still trying to play. They're still trying to play the football. They're still trying to exploit some of the weakness that they feel are in the Leeds outfit. And I think all Ian will be speaking about is that execution element of what they're doing. I think they've only completed half their sets. It's a little bit reminiscent of us sometimes. It makes the game too hard, especially when it's warm and especially when the temperatures are going up and some of these engines are steaming a little bit, then those things can happen. So that's what he'll be talking about. Daryl Powell will be delighted. He'll be disappointed that they're not more than 6 points up, because that's one score away from the champions. And we all know they can get back into any game at 6 points.
Yes, if Saints get a roll on, they can, but they've got to get hold of the football to do that. And Steve-O, quite frankly, Leeds have played, and if you were Daryl Powell, you'd be delighted. They've played almost the perfect 40 minutes.
Yeah, they certainly have. In fact, 17 times in possession, 16 times they've completed their sets of six. Now, with stats like that, you should be well and truly in control of this game, especially with the fact that St Helens were coming out with so many errors. And in fact, this is the first mistake. The kicking was good early. You can see there, lengthening shadows. The sun, obviously, was a big mistake there for Aid Garner. He couldn't get to it. Good work from Calderwood to put Walker in for the first try. They went back to basics. They were still making mistakes. But when you've got this guy on the field, Cunningham, he never gives in, does he? No doubt about the try. And then we came Connolly back into it. Stewart was down hurt here, but it was a good link. Dunaman loves to play out wide, but the inside running from the Leeds player just made Long hesitate to allow Connolly in for a try. And we were thinking, I wonder how many, and how many mistakes that Saints were doing in that first half. That was one of them from Smith, and from that position, this was a mile forward. See how he held it there. Connolly, and he's the reason why Sculthorpe hesitated. Long ball out wide here to Cummins. Little bit of lady luck there. And the Maguire, well, he came up with the error. It was Long that kicked for the post, hoping that he would get a ricochet. Didn't by the post, but certainly did from the youngster Maguire. And Cunningham in for a try. Then I'm quite certain that Ian Millwood would be saying to his players, we didn't get the rub of the green. The pass from Ferner definitely was forward. So therefore, they have a time where it does change around. And it's an amazing thing. A lot of coaches say, I wish it would not have got to halftime. Other coaches say, I'm very, very glad they've got into it. And I think this is the moment that Ian Millwood will be saying to these Chargers, we're in with a great chance. Don't worry about it.
Well, they are, because 6 points in the modern game is absolutely nothing. And Phil Clark, when they have been outplayed, and they have, the champions in the first half, when they've been outplayed like that and they're still within cooey at halftime, they must be confident. Back to the confidence word.
Yes, I would probably agree with you. We've talked about how well Leeds have controlled their possession, but at times they've also had fantastic defence as well. They've had that willingness to try and keep St Helens deep inside their own half, and it's that defence really that has helped them really build that six-point lead. Here we saw some great technique there from Matt Diskin to hit up under the ball and drive his opponent back. Then McDonald put a shot on Darren Britt.
Yeah,
but you know, one of the turning points I thought in the first half was when Sean Long put in that extra effort. When your team aren't going well, you need somebody to stand up and do something special. And Sean Long did exactly that. Not only a great kick, but he followed up with a chase. And this is where St Helens are most dangerous, when Cunningham and Higham start to run from dummy half. On that occasion, they release Paul Wellens. And if a Leeds allow them to do that, then they're into big trouble. We talked about just how well Leeds have completed possession, but you know, it's not everything hanging onto it. It's how well you use it when you've got it that really counts. And that's the worrying side now, as we've talked about, for Daryl Powell and the Leeds side in the second half.
You talk about worries for Leeds and also worries for St Helens. There was one point in that first half, Clarky, where Sean Long looked as though he'd picked up an injury. Do you think he came into this game 100%?
Well, I think as the half grew on, he seemed to run off whatever the problem was, and I thought the effort really to trap Connolly in the in-goal area showed just how much energy he's got left for the game. One worry maybe for St Helens is the fact that Chris Joint may not come back on, and this game now, played at the speed it is a full game for all 17 players. It's very difficult if you lose one of your troops and you have to do it with only just 16 or even less, but that'll be the test for St Helens in the second half.
Thanks, Phil. Keep a close eye on the events in the second half, won't you? Because your vote, along with Brian and Steve-O, will produce a man of the match for us. And he goes home with the watch tonight, as he always does on a match night here on Sky Sports. Brian Noble, let me ask you to pin your colours firmly to the mast now. Who's going to win in the second half?
Well, I mean, we've all alluded to the fact that the team that controls the ball, I don't think it will. I think it'll be the daring team, the team that wants to make a play, the team that maybe wants to get itself out of the mire and re-kickstart its season.
You're talking about St Helens.
Well, I just noticed, and I pick up on what Clarkie said about Leeds' early defence. They got forward and they bashed Saints. They forced some of those errors that we were talking about. If Leeds come out with the same mentality, then I think Leeds will come home with a win. However, it's one of these, however, who'd be a coach or who'd be a caller? If Saints execute their plays properly, then I think Saints will go away with a win.
I think Mr. Noble is sitting on the fence for once in his wonderful life, but we won't press him any further on that. We'll just let the action unfold for you here on Sky Sports. It's a great game, isn't it? It's another Friday night thriller on Sky Sports from the Tetley Super League, and there's only 6 points in it. This game isn't over yet.
Yeah, engineers. We seem to have a problem with a man's tie stuck in the till.
Just pull it out.
Well, how long? Oh.
Oh, can you stop this, please?
Hello?
Are you the manager?
Yes. They're on the way. It'll be about 20 minutes.
20 minutes? Something has to be done now.
Just a minute.
Would the owner of the silver Skoda Fabia please report to the information desk immediately? Thank you.
Where do flies go in the winter?
Lanzarote.
If only everything was as simple as BT Together's new pricing options. At evenings and weekends, a whole hour costs just 6p. Another good reason to come back to BT. Reconnect for free. Call 0800 800 810.
Five million pixels, but no eye for a good photo.
It can feel like airborne allergies are taking you over, but Flixonase Allergy can help you feel yourself. And spraying just once could last all day. New Flixonase.
Suddenly, the man on the telly said something incredible.
Incredible! Halifax now pays 4.05% interest on fixed savings.
4.05%? Skyscraping? Does anyone else pay as much?
Our banks don't.
That's balmy! And how could you put this right?
Switch to Halifax. Number one bank for savings.
Oh, meow. That set the cat out of the bag.
Exhibit A, proving that Halifax one-year fixed savings offers doobie-doo extra value.
Open and shut case.
And your verdict?
Who gives you extra? Who? We do. Who gives you extra?
If you want to find out more about different jobs in the army, just call 08457 300 111.
It's their most incredible free flights offer ever. The Mail is giving every reader a free scheduled return flight to any one of 10 fabulous holiday destinations. You choose where you want to go. Yes, your chosen destination guaranteed. There's a free return flight for everyone to the destination of your choice, starting in tomorrow's Daily Mail.
This Sky One Sunday, all new Fear Factor at 9. Have they got the guts for it?
Ring in the worm.
Three. Two,
one. All uncut and all new Kirsty Tone videos at 10. She's back and she's after a man. The all new Anna Nicole Show at 11.
Why don't you tell us what you're looking for?
Hi, gather her muscles.
It's all new and it's all here this Sky One Sunday from 9 o'clock.
Great choice of live international rugby union tomorrow at 7:30 in the morning. The All Blacks take on England, followed at 10 by Australia against Wales. Then from 2, it's South Africa against Scotland. Those three matches are on Sky Sports 1. And on Sky Sports Extra from 7 in the evening, it's Argentina against France in the first of 2 test matches. This is the Tetley Super League in half-time at Headingley. Leeds 16, the champions St Helens 10. And here are the statistics, and the times in possession is the teller. 17 for Leeds and 16 sets completed. 17 for the Saints and 9 completed. And 17 minutes in the opposition half. And missed tackle count for Saints is rising. 14 as against 4. And there are the top performers in the various disciplines. Now, I hate to try and blind you with science, but if we look at this halfway stage of the season, the way that the two sides here score and concede tries, this is a purple patch for both of them. On average, during the course of the 41st to 60th minute, Leeds have scored 19 tries this year. The Saints have scored 22. Crucially, the Saints have let in that same period, 14. Leeds have let in just 7. So a critical part of the match has just started on referee Carl Kirkpatrick's whistle. Who will gain the upper hand? Mickey Higham with the run from dummy half, halted by Keith Senior. Long dummy half this time, and here comes Bennett again.
Fair relay!
This is probably going to be the most important 10-15 minutes for St Helens in the entire season. They have to build a platform, and in doing so, build that confidence. We know we've gone on about it time and time again, but it is so important in sport these days, and rugby league is no exception.
Deep kick from Sean Long is too deep. Let's get the half-time news from Bill. Early call, Bill.
Well, both coaches reasonably pleased with those first half efforts, and particularly Daryl Powell there. The only complaint he had was the actual composure when they got to the finishing end of things. Up to that point, his team had been magnificent. Kicking game could be improved on in the second half, but really it's composure when they get in that Saints red zone and making most of the great possession that they've had and the great sets of six. The completion rate has been fantastic. It's just what they've done with it, and that's where he's looking to improve. Whereas St Helens coach Ian Millwood really impressed with the defensive effort from his side that's largely kept them in this game. They've got to cut out these errors, because that's what's handed Leeds all the possession and the territory. If they can do that and be a bit more clinical in their finishing, then of course they reckon that they can make the most of the situation that they found themselves in. Only 6 points adrift, it could be a lot worse, and then they've got the ball back now. They won't have Chris Joint back though, because it is a broken nose for the Saints skipper.
Nasty bang for Joint, and not the best start for Chev Walker to the second half. First time they had the ball in hand, and Leeds this time did not complete their set.
Good play as well by Paul Wellens, got right into the face of the big centre Chev Walker, brought about the mistake.
This is Darren Smith now. He peeled away from the base of the scrum there.
As I said at half-time, Eddie, rugby league has a wonderful ability to just turn things around when we get into the second stanza.
Here goes Mickey Hyan from dummy half. Hauled back by the biggest man on the field, Wayne McDonald. It's Tim Yonkers looping past to Sean Long. Goes wide to Sculthorpe. And Sculthorpe standing, eventually hitting the deck. Maguire. And also there was Willie poaching. Sean Long. Sean Long to Yonkers. Back to Long. That went backwards, but Duneman has it anyway.
Well, he came up with the edit, but he really should have dropped onto that football a lot quicker. I was just about to praise the fact that Sean Long looks as though he means business in his second half, and then the mistake with the ball going backwards. You really have to fight for it. And that's the difference between the two sides, is that Leeds want possession. They really want to win this game.
Yes, they're very eager. Sinfield, McDermott carrying with one hand as normal. Gets to his feet. Diskin, McDonald. More good yards from McDonald, just up towards the halfway line. Diskin to Maguire. Here's the kick from Danny Maguire. Good kick too down the line. Turns Darren Albert around. Albert not too secure under the long kicks in the first half. Tips it inside to Anthony Stewart. Stewart plays the ball. It's Albert again. Aidy Gardner now. They're all coming into dummy half for Saints, trying to get themselves involved in this match. As Steve-O says, a critical match and a critical 20 minutes here for the champions in the terms of their season. Remember, we said before the match began, if they lost this, they would be 7 victories behind Leeds Rhinos at the top of the table, and that could be far too much to make up. Hyam, dummy half. Sculthorpe dabs the ball over the top, will turn Francis Cummings around, and Connolly collected in his own in goal area, and Saints get the ball back from the goal line dropout courtesy of Albert's charge.
You'll feel much better with that. It really dinked badly, and that was a good effort. Really got involved. Nervous times in that first 40 minutes. But all the experience in the world, not as much as this fella, Gary Connolly. He made sure he was in a good position. And a very casual approach to rugby league, but my oh my, he's been a wonderful servant to our game.
And the referee has called time off because Leeds are in no hurry particularly to take this goal line dropout.
Well, someone's injured.
No, I think Gary Connolly's lost his boot, hasn't he? Or is he injured? He's receiving some running repairs. Time off. Maybe it's just a change of footwear, I think, Steve-O.
Well, you shouldn't stop the game for that. Carry on.
Well, he didn't, but they were taking an eternity, Leeds, and so, to be fair to St Helens, that's why he stopped the clock, I think.
Well, it's his problem, and surely the referee should have noticed that. Maybe he was confused because the man helping Connolly was the actual water carrier.
Mickey Hyam with a little run from dummy half, and it went back off Bennett, and here is Anthony Stewart. Great scrambling defence again though from Leeds. Here is Mickey Hyam. Good run from Hyam. Clawed to the ground by Matt Diskin.
He could be the game breaker. They've got to keep an eye on him.
Long will attack the line. Good ball to Sculthorpe. He gets away from Dunham. Feeds Wellens. Wellens tries to come inside too, and does. Wellens over the line. What an effort. What an effort from Paul Wellens. Fantastic try from the St Helens fullback. His first try of the season came against Wigan last week. We've just seen try number two of 2003.
Magnificent effort. It was all brought about by the lovely little run there from Mickey Hyam, and then Sean Long set them up. That wasn't the best attempt in defence. Daryl Powell will be not impressed with this. Runs across, skirts it. Sculthorpe did well. They had the dummy runner. That's about the first time that Saints in this game have utilised someone coming back from the second phase. And what an effort that is. Whoa. Nothing short of superb. Game on.
Well, he got a try here in the 35-20 victory in 2000. He injured a cheekbone, remember, after just 3 minutes of last year's grand final. Missed the test series because of that. But Paul Wellens' try has put St Helens back in this match, and if Long can kick this goal, the scores will be level at Headingley. As the sun dips behind the trees behind this famous old ground, Long measures this kick, knows how important it is. And he's pulled it wide. 16-14.
Dummy runner coming across, but you can see how Willie Poaching has just decided to hang about instead of getting across. If he'd have gone early, he really should have been in a position to stop Wellens there. They went to sleep. And for once this season, Paul Wellens can think to himself, things maybe about to change.
Well, why is Paul Sculthorpe not taking the goal kicks tonight? Bill Arthur, I understand, is on the case. Inspector Gadget will bring us the details. Mickey Hyam. Sean Long is the dummy half for St Helens. Keith Mason now. Darren Smith waits at dummy half. And it's with Jason Hooper. He got away from McDonald, but not away from Ferner and Poaching. Hyam, here's Long again. 18-14, 10 minutes of the second half at the JJB Stadium. Great game there, great game here. This is the Tetley Super League. Great games all over the show. And this is Albert. Mickey Hyam, Sean Long. Sean Long has backed himself. Connolly slipped, but Connolly collected it.
Good chase, more enthusiasm. Just before the half-time break in the final 10 minutes of the first half, saw on a couple of occasions that St. Helens only just one and two were moving up on the chase. Now they're going as a unit.
Trying to answer a few questions, St. Helens tonight, but the league leader's still ahead and in possession for a moment, and Darren Smith will hack it forward, but Ferner was there to tidy up. McDonald has dropped it, and that's the second set not completed.
Ian Millwood would make sort of a situation saying, anything you can do, we can do. And we did it better in the first half, and that's so many mistakes. Now the dropsy has turned around to the Rhinos. Now then, let's see this scrum on the other occasion. Watch for the loose forward. He'll peel away Jason Hooper. Now he's got to wait until the ball is out the back.
And that was legal. There's nothing wrong with that.
I know.
Here is Sean Long, and he's attacking them. Keith Senior wrestles him to the ground. Senior just delaying long enough before he got to his feet. Keith Mason!
Good run. That is a lot more punch there as well.
Here's Tim Yonkers. Tries to go inside McDonald. Helped out by Ferner again. Hyam waits at dummy half. Dangerous moments for the Leeds Rhinos. On the half volley, Long picks it up. Gives it to Darren Smith. Hooper is the runner. Good tackle by Sinfield. Big second half position has swung St Helens' way. It's with Darren Smith again. Smith gives it back to Long. Long gives it to Hyam. Quick hands on to Hooper. They're underneath the sticks on the fifth and last, St Helens. It's with Hyam attacking the line. Scunthorpe couldn't take the pass. And Diskin gratefully accepts the gift. Here is Calderwood. He's away from Long.
Well, not a bad effort there, but why on earth do you put a man like Scunthorpe coming through on a short ball? They've lost the position.
They've and they're penalised here for not standing square at the play of the ball.
Kev, keep them tidy. Keep them all tidy.
No doubt about it. Mickey Hyam never attempted. Just peeled away.
Mason was the other involved. He wasn't standing square either.
Well, it made it worse by the fact that Hyam had moved away about a yard to his left.
Well, it's amazing, Phil, isn't it? Half-time comes at the right time for some, wrong time for others.
Well, we've just seen a great 10-minute period from the St Helens side. When in possession, a lot of more players running from dummy half and then offloading to supporting players. And when you see them do that, that's what they like to do the most. Brings the most edge to the players they have in the squad and suits them the best. You see now they've upped that since the half-time. Leeds really, a couple of shaky handling errors, and all of a sudden, greater desire and enthusiasm and speed, really, of the defensive line from the St Helens side. Certainly lifted the side there, as I think we'll see another penalty for a high shot on Andrew Duneman.
Yes, the high shot on Andrew Duneman has been penalised by Carl Kirkpatrick. I reckon Kevin Sinfield might have a shot at goal here.
Well, it's pretty hard to say conclusively that that was a...
It was Darren Smith.
Went straight in, off the chest, right up into the face. Well spotted by... Carl Kirkpatrick, I must say, handled this game quite well.
He's had some big matches this season, Steve. As I said at the start, he's had Leeds Bradford, he's had Wigan Saints, now he's got this.
Let's hope that Stuart Cummins, right, he controlled the referee. Let's hope that we play the same situation as we should with all sports, is that you pick the man that is on the top form. It's the same when you're selecting representative teams, you pick the players that are producing the goods at the time. Sentimentality has to go out the window, and as you say, and it's very rare you'll hear me say this, that this guy has improved throughout this year, and I've got to start thinking about maybe he gets an even bigger game than this.
Sinfield with the penalty, hits the post and slides over. The luck is going the Rhinos' way. 18-14. 18-14 to the league leaders, ahead of the champions. By the way, our match referee tomorrow evening at Halifax, Steve Gatz. Ian Millwood and John Sharp on the side for Saints. Scunthorpe with the kickoff, high and hanging. Maguire is underneath it. Here is Chris Feather.
That's an important 2 points for Leeds, and they know it. They're a little bit shaky. A tremendous start by St Helens.
But a more enthusiastic chase from dummy half, and the defence is up in Leeds' face, which it wasn't in the first half, that is for sure. And here is Sinfield, he tried to stride out of the tackle by Hyam and couldn't. Diskin, Maguire.
Kept him pretty quiet. They forced him out on an angle rather than go towards him. He's got a wonderful step.
Here's the last tackle. That's why the kick from Sinfield went in, but it wasn't the best. It was straight down the throat of Anthony Stewart. And Saints will try and counter from the full-back. Quick play the ball now. Offside against Leeds.
Not standing square
again.
He's getting it right for both sides. Frustration creeping into both of them. We mentioned midway through that first half that the amount of defence that Saints had been going through, that they perhaps would be the side that would tire. But once the adrenaline is pumping through and you get yourself on a roll, you just watch them. If Saints get back and go for a try in the next 5 or 6 minutes, boy, oh boy, went in for a thriller.
Gleeson.
Go on!
St Helens back within 17 metres of the line. Hyam. And here is Long, back on the inside to Yonkers. It's a much better start to the second half from the champions, this. Hyam, Long, Scunthorpe, looks for the runner. He's out wide, and again it went behind him. It was Wellens, and they lost the momentum there.
Well, they both went up in a straight line into attack. There was no second phase of it. But they're playing the ball a lot quicker, and also Sean Long's getting more involved into the game.
Scunthorpe! Flick pass into the arms of Ryan Bailey. Leeds have it back. Let's go down to Bill. I think he's got news, has he, of the injury?
Eddie, it's a bit of a mystery, really, because Paul Scunthorpe wasn't in bad form kicking against Wigan last weekend. He kicked five. I think he missed with a couple of attempts, though. So whether it's a confidence thing, and Sean Long really fancied the job this evening. He has, after all, kicked 44 already this season. Whether that's the case, I don't know, but his confidence is still strong. I think he still fancies the job.
Well, Sean Long with the goal kicking this evening. There is no injury then to Paul Scunthorpe. And here is Dooneman, who's given it wide to Walker. He tried to get that ball away. Hooper was the most keen. And he was brave as well, because the boots were flying there.
Picked up an injury as well, but that's the difference. Looking for it, wanted it. Bit suspect forward pass anyway to Walker. Maybe they got their just desserts, did Saints.
Wonder if Ian Millwood said, look, come on, we are the champions, let's go out and play like champions. Because he's done something at half-time to them, that's for sure. An inspirational half-time talk so far. Higham will attack them.
Great effort. He's put the spark back into him. More runs from dummy half. But Long. They're making inroads, Eddie.
They're lining up left. It's Darren Smith. Darren Smith all the way, is he? He's held up just short.
Great defence. That was on the power play.
Well, that ball was played.
It doesn't
that
matter.
Ball was played, I think.
It doesn't matter. The referee's already called for the handover.
He said, handover, play the ball. That's what Jason Hooper's saying. And I think Leeds played the ball. And I think Hooper touched down.
Well, it was great defence, wasn't it? Dooneman coming to the rescue.
It's what happens after this. Play the ball. Official. Oh, he wasn't playing
was
properly now.
No, he was kicked.
No.
To me.
Well done, Carl Kirkpatrick again.
I'll tell you
glad
what.
He wasn't watching.
Didn't matter, he had to blow the whistle anyway. That's why it was never going to be a try. But nervous times for the Rhinos. Remember, there's been quite a few occasions this season where they've just scraped home by the odd 1 point.
Indeed. And they've kept this young man quiet tonight, Danny Maguire. Having said that, we haven't seen Rob Burrow on the field yet, and when he gets on, anything can happen.
What does
he
see?
He's just warming up right now as I speak.
You could either call him the secret weapon, because everybody knows about him, don't they?
He's so difficult to stop, though, and he's waiting to be given his chance. This is the last tackle. Sinfield, hit late by Hooper.
Very late. No indication from the touch judge. It's all getting a bit... Oh, Fowler's got in with a haymaker. It's on. Well, they're going after the wrong ball. It was Fowler to me that really went in with a haymaker.
Well, he did at the end, but there was some pushing and shoving going on prior to that. And the referee has to be a bit careful here. He could lose control of this.
And he went late, as far as I'm concerned. No doubt about it, the Hooper, and you could see that Collingwood was starting it. And that was a big hit from Ferner. He lost his cool completely.
Couldn't be quite sure.
Well, we just mentioned the fact that...
With his arm or his elbow in the face or not. But Albert, when the player had been kicked through, actually took out a player late. It needs to go on report, OK? And there's a late challenge on the kicker.
OK.
OK, we'll put the challenge.
Well, the whole thing is
challenge
on
over there on report. We're going to penalise Darren Albert for the elbow.
Well, Darren Albert is penalised for the elbow. It's a Leeds penalty.
But why did we have to go so far?
The elbow.
And Scunthorpe was asking the question, why didn't the touch judges run in the first instance? Now, you can't tell me that he's been given the information. OK, we know that went on, but the late tackle, there was no movement. I was watching both of them.
Great offload there by Poaching under pressure. Back it comes to Sinfield. There's a game on here. Cunningham caught him a bit high. play the ball to Diskin. Here is Chris Feather back to Diskin. This is Ryan Bailey. St Helens with it all to do in defence. Diskin. Diskin slips under pressure. Penalty to St Helens. He didn't play the ball. He lost the referee's words in his ear then because of the racket that's going on. The referee clearly shouted play the ball and Diskin moved off the mark and tried to continue on.
Now this is a high shot.
Well, it's late, not high, but was it late or was it committed? Well, it's a decision they'll have to make.
Jason Hooper goes for it, right? Now then, it was late and he committed himself.
That is the incident on report, not the other business.
Yeah, I realise that, but why didn't they come on in the first instance then? If he's confident that it needs putting on report, why on earth is he just at the edge on the whitewash with his merry flag?
This is getting tasty now.
That's two. Release.
We have a quarter of the match to go, and Wigan are ahead by 20 points to 4 against Hull. 14, I beg your pardon. 20 points to 14 against Hull. And here is another penalty for St Helens. And Phil, suddenly the pendulum has swung Saints' way a bit.
Let's keep it all tidy as it was. Okay?
Pace, Eddie, the pace, the intensity, the aggression has increased as to as the penalty count quite recently. And those two lucky penalties there now that have gone in favour of St Helens have put them back on the attack. Thought they did well to repel the Leeds attack on their own line. I disagree with you two. I didn't think it was a late challenge on Sinfield for the kick. Hey, but there's more going on than one controversial penalty.
Lost it.
Knock on against Bennett.
No doubt about it, he lost it. The official is absolutely spot on. So he loses control there. Maybe he was helped with Mr. Calderwood's left arm. Either way, tense moments for both coaches, especially Ian Millwood. Still 4 points adrift, but they're in a good position. It's important they don't give away a silly penalty now.
This is Connolly.
They've got to keep applying the pressure so that when Leeds get to do the kick and chase, Saints will be in a position to bring it back to the halfway line. That's what you've got to play for.
That's Chris Feather. He's yet to make his full debut. All his 13 appearances off the bench. Here is Ryan Bailey, one of the best young prop forward prospects we've got knocking around the British game. And Diskin's waiting at dummy half. He finds Sinfield, who gives it to Duneman. Back on the inside to Connolly. Great hands on to Sinfield. Here is Bailey again. Wrestled to the ground by Cunningham. Oh, Gleeson could have been penalised then. Last tackle, Maguire dabs the ball over the top, turns Darren Albert around, Cummins is after him, gives the ball inside to Stewart, Maguire gets to him. Stewart, tackle now completed by Ferner. Darren Albert from dummy half, under pressure from Bailey.
Good quick play the ball though from St Helens and that's giving them the momentum.
Good
work as well. Great to see from the three quarters, taking the pressure off the forwards.
Cunningham to Darren Britt. Britt taking it on himself. The support is there from Cunningham. Good work from Duneman again. He has been magnificent all year.
You can see the stat there that was up previously in regards to 22 runs from dummy half. The mere fact that Mickey Higham has been brought on certainly changes the fortunes of this St Helens side.
Another St Helens player is down. Is it Wellens? I think it is. Nasty kick across the face of goal. Well picked up by Cummins. Yonkers gets to him eventually. And Wellens bravely will carry on. Oh, here comes Calderwood.
Beautiful play, you know, from Francis Cummings.
Here's Rob Burrow. Finds Keith Senior. Good tackle by Darren Albert. Burrow bouncing around. Maguire. On to Ferner. And he's grounded by Darren Smith. 2:30-somethings there. Burrow. Duneman. Sculthorpe gets him. Last tackle, good defensive effort here by St Helens. Burrow to the captain Sinfield, closed down by Cunningham.
Ooh,
to Ryan
forward.
Bailey, out the back door to Feather. Here is Gary Connolly. Connolly wide to Senior. They're going to get away with this. It's with Cummins. Cummins down the line. And Stewart with an excellent tackle.
I mean, the turnover, full credit. Not so sure that Daryl Powell was too impressed. He thought maybe the kick would have been a better option, but they chanced their arm.
And they looked for a moment, Steve, as though they were going to get away with it.
I must say, There was a few dodgy passes right across the line. They were flicking it behind their back. They've got to remember that they are the team in front.
Brick will drive it in again. Last quarter of an hour, 4 points in it. The league leaders ahead of the champions. And the champions trying to come back at them all the time. Hooper plays the ball to Sculthorpe. Here is Tim Yonkers. He's through Ryan Bailey. He's not through Chris Feather. Sculthorpe again. Sean Long attacking the line. Passes to Gleeson. Gleeson stabs it forward, gets it back.
Back to six.
Now on the last, he says. Long with the crossfield kick. Chev Walker's under this.
Well, I got the impression that Singfield got an arm to that. That should have been back to six there.
No penalties, come on.
He tries an awful kick. Singfield touches it. Gleeson picks it up. That should have been six more.
To release! Release!
See better from this angle. Yeah, he certainly plays it. It's Maguire, not Sinfield. My apologies to the loose forward and captain of Leeds, but
should have been another set of six for Saints. As it is, it's Bailey driving it out, and Cunningham standing his ground. Burrows the dummy half. Here is Sinfield. Now it's with Dooneman. Here is Walker, and he's got Calderwood, the speed merchant, outside him. But Aidy Gardner wasn't going to let him get past. That's the last. Burrows in at dummy half. Dooneman now will hoist the big deep kick. Oh, they're going to let it bounce. He's offside!
This will be a gift, 2 points. What on earth are they doing? Well, it looked like they have just absolutely cleaned the slate as it comes down to making errors. And he allowed it to bounce. It isn't as though he was under pressure.
You could tell, Steve-O, just by looking at that, they were going to let it bounce. Yeah, nobody had the confidence to go for it.
Yeah, but why did he touch it?
All right, Steve, yeah.
Throws it away. Well,
turns all right.
A gift, 2 points. And
amazingly, though, all this at the end of a set of six, that St Helens should have had another set of six up the other end.
Well, I'll take a pill, because I've agreed with you. For the entire game, it's been one of those wonderful, wonderful matches.
It's a shame that it might be settled on mistakes like that, but poor old Darren Albert's come up with a few this evening.
And sadly, Mr. Kirkpatrick has come up one that will prove extremely vital.
Well, he needs help from his touch judges, and
well,
I go back to that point I made earlier. The touch judges are giving them no help this year.
Well, and then when something flares up, they do come on and say, "Oh, you put that on report."
And there's a fourth official in the stand, of course. Sinfield goal, doesn't make any mistake. It's 20 points to 14. And it's 2014 here at Headingley. And it's 2014 at Wigan, last we heard. So two real scraps going on in the higher echelons of this wonderful competition called the Super League. Fingers are pointing, voices are being raised on the coaches' benches. It's a nervous last 11 and a half minutes or so. And controversy all over the show. Well, he nearly got it, Gardner. Who got the first knock on? Was it the Leeds man, Walker?
Well, will the touch judge help?
Leeds get the head and feed. And he's right.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Let's go. Mind you, doesn't that mean that Gardner was offside if Wellens touched it?
Put the ball in the scrum.
I thought Chev Walker got a fingertip to it there. Yeah. But
Dooneman for Leeds.
I was just going to make the point, Eddie, before Leeds came up with those two vital points, is that they were looking a little bit tired. They weren't getting back into their one line of defence as quick as what we've seen throughout this game.
Seniors away from one. He nearly got away from the second man again. It was Darren Albert.
Ooh, nearly put his foot in a touch there.
Burrow to Ferner.
I will be thinking about the 1 point.
28-14, 10 minutes to go at the JJB Stadium. This is Sinfield trying to win the match for the league leaders. Burrow, dummy half. Dooneman called and got. Short pass! Connolly was nearly through.
Got to go for the 1 point.
He's hurt, Connolly.
Dooneman's getting himself into a good position. Sculthorpe, Kevin Sinfield, should I say, will stand and make sure that no one comes to charge him down. I'm sure that's what they said. And you can see Kevin Sinfield, Stenazzo is going to get the first marker to his right.
Here's Dunamis. He goes for the one-pointer and he had all the time in the world. And he scored it. You picked it. He's missed it. He's missed it.
Oh, it looked as though it was open.
It did. From this angle, it looked as though it was right between the woodwork.
Well, it was the right option, wasn't it? They thought Sinfield was going to run for it. And on it was
a fraction wide.
Yep. If you can call 3 feet to fraction, I'll be along with you.
That didn't look like 3 feet either.
Yeah, well, you've never done my carpets.
Jason Hooper, oh, he's ducked under one.
And as I mentioned, getting back to that problem, which is obviously becoming worse for this Leeds outfit. Oh, that's great. Great defence.
Dunamis all over Scunthorpe like a rash.
Didn't play
Not
correct.
The tidiest play of the ball. Smith, Hyam, Cunningham.
See Leeds not getting into their faces.
This is Mason, they're in his face.
As they did in the first half.
Cunningham down the short side. Scunthorpe stabs it along. Difficult for Connolly. Difficult for Connolly. He's buried. Clarkey. Brian Noble sat on the fence at half-time. Who are you backing?
Oh, I'll go all the way and say Saints win here. Try from this goal line dropper. You know, on two occasions previously in this match, they put a great chase in when they put the kick into the in-goal area. What a goal line dropper and come up with two tries as a result of that. Let's go for a third-time lucky. You know, there has been a fantastic game. The fact it's come down to the last 10 minutes just goes to show really the quality of the game. Gary Connolly still in trouble, but will stay out there. One of the most impressive things, though, I think, for Leeds this year, we've talked about the razzle-dazzle. You know, if Leeds are a sports car, then I suppose the interior leather and the alloy wheels are Burrow and Maguire. But the engine and the real power and performance come from the forefront rowers, Bailey, McDonald, Feather and McDermott. They've been awesome.
Well, that was on the first tackle and they couldn't get the ball to each other.
Well, I know they're running out of time, but this is just sheer stupidity and he knows it. There's the man in charge. Didn't have to do that. Why on earth do you want to offload the ball? Gleeson at fault, they made a right meal of it.
Darren Albert actually could have got to it, but just lost it on the bounce.
But what's the point of offloading?
Exactly.
He was going down in the tackle. Take the tackle.
This is Adamson. 7 minutes and a wee bit to go, and McDermott is back. And the trumpet sounds on the south stand. That's the signal for something special. And here's McDonald.
But a big battle between McDonald and Keith Mason. Been fascinating to watch. What a big shoulder hit there from Cunningham.
And he says, come here, and nearly drops it straight through the ground. Another drop goal attempt by Sinfield is wide. Well, they're getting a bit anxious, Leeds. They want to stretch that advantage to 2 scores.
Hold it. It's a good option, Eddie.
Of course it is.
Just keep going for it.
I don't kick him on, Mickey. Get back, eh?
Still have a twist to this game. I just get the impression that...
Well, Leeds have drawn 2 of the last 3 on this ground. Another score for Saints. They could be drawing another. Gardner.
I just think that Mickey Hyam is a man that could just come up with something.
Here he goes. Hyam to Hooper. Hyam again to Cunningham.
Looked a touch forward.
Keith Mason. Good ball out the back to Long. Here is Hooper again. Hooper just committed Burrow to the tackle. They're trying to force him over the line. Senior's all over the top of him. Albert waits at dummy half. This is Sean Long. Long to Stewart.
Pretty high.
High shout, yes.
That's the second one from Ferner.
David Ferner, the man picked out by the referee.
Yep, no doubt about it.
Well, this is a chance for St Helens now. Cunningham, Darren Britt, Keith Mason, Ferner shot out of the line, flick pass.
Back to 6.
Well, that was a knock-on by Dunamis.
Took the gamble, flicked the ball away. Could find himself in trouble with that. Again, they were trying to keep it alive. They know that time is against them. He knows they've just got to get possession.
Inspired signing, Andrew Duneman. Now then, St Helens, five to go, behind on the scoreboard. And it's all in the script, isn't it, that Saints fight back and win matches like this. Let's see. Sculthorpe. Adamson having a second go at him. Cunningham finds... Oh, he doesn't find anyone. Long hacks it forward.
Oh, that's got to
Senior
be
was taken
penalty.
Out. Senior took him out.
Took Long out. Oh, just get the play on.
He's given the knock-on.
It's ball, Frank. Frank!
Well, he's calling to the touch, Judge.
Come down. Please ball.
Well, he's got to be taken now.
Pull him up. Pull him up.
He's given the knock-on against Sean Long, I feel.
Oh, against Jason Hooper.
Pull him up.
Well, what about taking the man out with not in possession of the football?
I think I just heard him say ball and all.
Where's your loose forward?
Ball and all. He never touched it with his hands. He touched it with his foot.
Or he said he was committed, maybe. I don't know.
Come on.
Well, he can't believe it.
Well, St Helens desperate for the ball back now, and Leeds only need to play safety first and kick. Wigan have beaten Hull 28-14 at the JJB Stadium. That's an important win for Wigan. Burrow!
Oh, release! To the line!
Disappointing night for Sean McRae, who's not been well this week.
Well, Leeds have to play what we call boring football. It's been a classic so far, but this is the time where they don't do anything silly.
Good kick, though, this. And Sinfield is leading the race. Gardner's away from him. No, he isn't. That's a great effort from the Leeds captain. Penning St Helens back in their own half. Yonkers to drive it forward again. But Ferner and Maguire, big in defence. Long. Here goes Mason. Cunningham, Darren Britt.
Well, you made the point, you know, that kick and chase there from the skipper, Kevin Sinfield. He's had a wow of a game tonight. He's been everywhere.
Sean Long, Paul Sculthorpe. Wide it goes to Wellens. Great tackle, Rob Burrow. Darren Smith on the last tackle here, Saints. Hoof and hope, maybe. The chase has got to be enthusiastic. Cummins catches it on the fly. Can the Saints snatch a draw? Can Leeds just put them to bed in the last 2.5 minutes? Senior, Cunningham's after him like a terrier.
Didn't like the slap across the face. Big grin all over Cunningham's face too.
Connolly.
Well, I get the impression that St Helens will probably get one more set of six. That's about it, because Leeds will just pile it up, then get the big...
Oh, he's lost it!
Come up with a bad mistake!
There's the mistake Saints are looking for!
No advantage.
You're not sure. Just come down.
And he says they had the ball stolen, Barry McDermott. And Long did!
Yeah, but there was no one else to touch him.
You lost it in the impact.
It was going backwards. You know, there isn't a situation in the game we've had this year, Eddie, where... This new rule has created problems, hasn't it?
All the time, Albert!
What a tackle by Duneman, and what an outstanding game he's had too.
Sculthorpe, Darren Smith again.
To release!
You know, a draw would be a fair result.
It would. Here is Mason. Oh, he's lost it now. I think that's it.
Well, he had to force it.
I think that's it, and I think Ian Millwood knows it.
Yep. Well, the lad had to force it. Knew the opportunity. See there that there was someone coming back on the inside, Mickey Higham.
Keep it tidy.
It just has not been his night, and as it's turning out, it's not Ian Millwood's season so far. All the glitter that's on the trophy that's on the sideboard back at Knowsley Road is starting to tarnish somewhat, but take nothing away from this Leeds outfit. Daryl Powell has got them working as a unit. We mentioned that 16 times out of 17 in possession in the first half. They completed their sets of six, and that's how they win games.
Indeed so. And this looks like being St Helens' fourth match without a win. And look at the completed sets. That tells its own story. I don't think there has ever been a run like this in Ian Millwood's reign at Knowsley Road. But Daryl Powell is standing proud tonight. This is the last tackle. McDonald, using all his experience, they'll surely just hoof the ball out. Well, maybe not. Magnificent, a great contest. Ian Millwood's men are wobbling like never before, and maybe now it will be a bridge too far as league leadership, second or third, is concerned. St Helens now must just, I think, look for qualification by getting into the top six. Another frantic Friday from the Tetley Super League. What a game! Leeds have won it by the narrowest of margins, just a try and a goal between these two fine sides. Leeds 20, Saints 14.
Placing you under arrest for the future murder of Sarah Marks.
There hasn't been a murder in 6 years. There's nothing wrong with the system.
We are arresting individuals who have broken the law.
But they will.
I have a warrant in my pocket that says murder.
Don't run.
He set me up.
Who's the victim?
I've never heard of him, but I'm supposed to kill him in less than 36 hours.
Precogs see the future, and they're never wrong. But it's not the future if you stop it.
Sometimes, in order to see the light, you have to risk the dark.
Minority Report, now showing on Sky Box Office.
As your needs change, can you change your mobile price plan whenever you like? You can with Perfect Fit from Vodafone.
Death Watch.
You wanna kill me?
Blows the horror genre to bits, screams loaded.
And I can't see this!
Rent it, buy it on DVD and video from Monday.
Lexus RX 300. You may need to remind yourself it's a 4x4.
Minnie Minoso, the Cuban Comet. 1957, he won baseball's first Golden Glove. He wasn't the fastest outfielder, didn't have the strongest or straightest arm, and as many could jump a hell of a lot higher. But out there, he'd get an inkling. When that ball flew, he'd be waiting for it. Put out 340 batters in just one season. But that's not luck. That's being in the right place at the right time. And that's what brings home the bacon.
Million pixels, but no eye for a good photo.
Yes! 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 Come on! Yes! You're gonna love this!
Because starting in tomorrow's Sun, one lucky reader will win £50,000 tax-free every year for the rest of their lives. That's 50 grand tax-free every year for life. It could be you.
Want help finding a mobile plan that really suits you? Pop into Vodafone and ask about Perfect Fit price plans.
I find squat bald men very attractive.
If only everything was as simple as BT Together's new pricing options. National calls now cost the same as local calls do. To sign up, call 0800 05 55 55.